Welcome to Audio Video System Playlist. I, Professor Hitesh Dholakia, is going to explain you MPEG in this session. So in this session, I'll explain MPEG means Motion Picture Expert Group. To explain this session based on MPEG, these are my session outlines. So first, I'll be going to explain basics of MPEG. Then after, I'll explain MPEG compression steps, as we provide MPEG standard to reduce size of data which is there with video. There are some standards which is there with compression. So all those steps that we will discuss it over here. Then after, in that steps, first I'll explain data preparation in MPEG standard. Then we will see data processing in MPEG standard. After that, I'll explain frame structure of MPEG by I, P and D frames. After that, I'll explain discrete cosine transform, quantization and entropy coding in MPEG. And at the end, I'll explain advantages and disadvantages of MPEG. So let us begin this session with first agenda, that is basics of MPEG. Now see, as I have told, MPEG full form is Motion Picture Expert Group. So based on this complete name, short initial has been MPEG. Standard for this MPEG is been utilized for encoding videos, movie and motion picture. And this is what we are utilizing to reduce size of video. MPEG has video extension with MP4 and audio extension with MP3. So this is one extension that we have it with MPEG. So when you apply this standard MPEG, one can have video extension with MP4 version and audio extension with MP3 version. You'll be finding there are different standards of MPEG that have evolved. Initially, it have started with MPEG 1. Then MPEG 2, MPEG 4, MPEG 7 and MPEG 21, that is how MPEG standards were there. So these are the different standards which is there with MPEG. Here in MPEG we use lossy video compression technique. So whenever you will be applying compression to video, in that case it is possible some data may get lost, but you will be finding there will be very high compression. So as you provide very high compression, size of video can be reduced to 1 by 15, 1 by 20 times. So for example, if you have video size that is there in terms of 100 of GB, and if you apply compression with 20 ratio, in that case, after compression, that video size will be 100 by 20, means 5 GB. So this will be a lossy video compression technique. But compression will be very high and reasonable loss is happening. It is not like very huge loss of video information will happen, but compression will be very high. So based on that, this standard has been utilized in video. And see, apply the similar technique. See, this MPEG that applies similar technique as it is there with JPEG for individual image. So we have already seen JPEG in previous session. Here we apply similar technique as it is there with JPEG. But to have a motion picture, you need to have a sequence of images. So in motion picture, there will be a sequence of images. In JPEG, there will be single image only. Now let us see MPEG steps. So basic first step that is there with MPEG, that is data preparation. Then after, we apply data processing. After that, we apply quantization, and at the end there will be entropy coding. Now see, this complete compression steps that I'll explain one by one, so it will be more clear how we provide compression to given video. Now see, data preparation in MPEG. So when you talk about data preparation, so in that there will be subsamples of chrominance signal. So whenever you have any signal which is there regarding MPEG, then there will be subsamples, and those subsamples that will be there with the ratio of 4:1:1. Now see here, this 4 that will be there regarding this Y, this one that will be there regarding this CB, and this one that will be there regarding CR. This Y that is giving information regarding luminance signal, and CB and CR that is giving information regarding chrominance signal. For NTSC signal, this luminance signal will be having resolution 352 x 240, and chrominance signal will be having resolution 176 x 120. While in case of PAL system, see, NTSC that is been utilized in America, and this PAL system that we use it in India. So this PAL system that is having this Y luminance signal, which is there with this resolution 352 x 288, while CB and CR chrominance signal will be having resolution 176 x 144. So this is how we are having data preparation in terms of luminance plus chrominance signal, and that ratio will be 4:1:1 in MPEG 1. And here, whatever one frame that we have, that we subdivide into macro blocks, 16 x 16 samples will be there for luminance component, and 8 x 8 samples that will be there for chrominance component, and combination of this many blocks that will make a image. Like see, for example, if you have this image like this, so that is what bisected into blocks, and size of individual block will be 16 x 16 for luminance component and 8 x 8 for chrominance component. So that is how we prepare data for MPEG. Now I'll explain you how data processing is happening in MPEG. So see, for that, here in data processing, first of all, we need to identify where motion is happening. So in data processing, we only change the data where motion is there. So here, main agenda is to identify motion prediction. So apply motion prediction at macro level. Then we change those blocks, right? So in most of the cases, for video, you need to predict those parts which is there in motion. You don't need to encode entire video for image, right? All you need to do is you just need to see which part is in motion, and that part only we need to encode. Other parts will remain same for entire video, so you don't need to encode it. So motion prediction is used to figure out where this macro block may be in the next frame. So for that motion prediction, there are three basic ways to have a prediction. Forward prediction, in that prediction is based on previous frame. Backward prediction, in that prediction is they are based on future frame. And bidirectional prediction, in which prediction will be there based on future as well as previous frames. So I'll explain you in frame structure how many types of frames are there. There are basically three types of frame where these algorithms that we use it to have a prediction of motion. So forward prediction, that will be predicting frame based on previous frame. Backward prediction, that is based on prediction for future frames. And bidirectional prediction, that is there with combination of previous and future frames. Now let us try to understand how frame is there. So IPB frames are there in MPEG. Here I, P and B, these three categories of frames which we have it in MPEG. So let us see first I frames. So see, I frames, that is independently coded. So there is no prediction in this frame. So these frames are independently coded where there will be no prediction. So we can start decoding based on I frames. So once we have I frames, we can apply prediction algorithm. So in I frames, there will be no prediction. Then there is P frames. So P frames are having forward prediction algorithm. So this is what we have it based on previous frames. So previous frames could be I frames or it could be P frames. So based on previous frame, we predict next frame, that is P frame. So that is based on forward prediction, and that prediction could be there from I frames or it could be there from P frames. And next is B frame, and that is bidirectional predicted frame where we have previous and following I frame P frames. So here I frames, that is independently coded, there is no prediction. P frames are coded based on forward prediction, and B frames, that is coded based on bidirectional prediction, that will be for future as well as previous frames. And see GOP, group of picture. So this group of picture explains a frame structure in between two I frames, and that is referred as group of picture. For example, if you see over here I B B P P B P I, so here in between these two I frames, so many frames are there. So this combination of frames, right, that will be I, that will be a frames in between two I frames, right, and that is even referred as group of picture. Like, see, one more example is there, I P P P I. So this is even one group of picture, well, where frames are there in between two I frames, and even one can have two I frames, so that is even a group of picture. So what is group of picture? It explains total frames in between two I frames. And this is what we are encoding based on prediction. So I is independently coded, B is bidirectionally coded, and P is coded based on forward prediction. So MPEG decoder may have to have buffer for extra frames of data beside being displayed. So when you display anything, before that you should have buffer so that you can have all those coding in MPEG decoder. Now I'll explain DCT in MPEG. So discrete cosine transform that we apply in MPEG, and basically we apply discrete cosine transform to reduce high frequency component, and you'll be having low frequency components only, and that we have it based on 8x8 data blocks. So there will be DC component and AC component. DC component will be having constant components, lower and AC lower frequency components, and AC components that will be having higher frequency components. And our agenda is to remove high frequency component here. So we provide discrete cosine transform. And here quantization is been done in MPEG, and we apply quantization based on frequency domain coefficients. So our agenda is to favor lower frequency coefficients, and we will be removing higher frequency coefficients. So it requires minimum data to store the video. Now see entropy encoding in MPEG. So when you see entropy encoding, then here we are dealing with to convert two dimensional data into one dimensional series. The reason is here at the end we need to store the image, and if you observe image, that will be two dimensional data. But here in memory we don't have that facility, so all we do is we translate that into one dimensional data. So that is how we have entropy encoding, and in that we use zigzag method to translate two dimensional data into one dimensional data. So zigzag scanning is been done, or one can go for vertical scanning. I'll show you zigzag scanning as we do it for JPEG even. You can see this is what this is how zigzag scanning is there, right? So this is 8x8 block is there with individual pixels that one can see. So 8 horizontal and 8 vertical pixels are there, and that is what we are scanning it by this zigzag method, right? And here we are concluding it. So this is how zigzag scanning is happening. One can have vertical scanning even, there is no issue in that. In MPEG this facility is even available, vertical scanning. And here we are applying run length coding on 1-day series even. So in run length coding, I have already explained that in JPEG, like the data which is there after that DCT and quantization, there will be removal of high frequency component. So few datas only we need to represent. So for that we apply run length coding. I'll show you that. See, after DCT and quantization, you'll be finding high frequency data are eliminated. So those are zero. So only this few datas are there. So based on zigzag, you'll be finding it will be like this, right? And you can see it is happening like this. So here only this 100, minus 60, 13 and minus 1, that we need to represent. So how we represent that? You see this 100. So here this 100 is there. And ahead of 100, number of zeros are 0. So this 0. And to represent this 100, 7 bits are required. So 0, 7, 100. So that gives you idea about how many zeros are ahead and what will be the number of bits with this data, and that is 100. And after zigzag, you will be finding after 100, that based on zigzag, after 100 you will be finding this minus 60 will be there. So again, ahead of 60, minus 60, zero number of zeros are there, so this 0. And to store minus 60, 6 bits are required, and minus 60, that is how it is written. And then after, you can see this zigzag will follow this path. So as it follows this path, right, how many zeros are there? 1, 2, 3, 4. So 4 zeros are there. So here 4, and to represent 6, 3 bits are required. And after this 6, you can see there are how many bits, which is 0, 3 bits. So you can see this 3 bits are 0, and to represent 13, 4 bits are required. And after this 13, there are 8 zeros, you can see this, and then minus 1 is there. So 8 zeros and minus 1, and minus 1 is required, minus 1 required 1 bit to represent it. So 8, 1, -1, that is how we are representing that in run length. And then after all zeros are there, so it is written like 0, 0. So you don't need to represent any further data. So if you observe this block, there are so many datas, but we are representing that by this much amount of information only. So this is so efficient. Now see, after that we apply Huffman coding. I have already made session based on Huffman coding, you can see that. And now we'll discuss advantages of MPEG. See, it produces very quality results with different compression level. So it is not like there are fixed compression standards. You can scale it even based on requirement. So to have higher resolution, we can provide lower scaling factor, lower compression factor. And but if you want more, less space with that video, in that case you should increase compression. It is compatible with most of the web browser. It is even compatible with most of the media software. And it is having better quality than AVI. Nowadays, very few people are using this format. But you'll be finding MPEG is giving far better resolution as well as quality compared to AVI. So there is a huge demand of MPEG compared to AVI. Thank you so much for watching this video. I would like to get your suggestions from your side. The reason is I want all those topics that has to be covered on my channel so that students can easily learn everything which is required in their university courses. And you can download all this material which I am teaching here from my application Engineering Funda. So I am providing all those material free of cost. You can download it. It will be easier to you to learn all those topics which I am teaching here. Again, thank you so much for watching this video, and your suggestions are most welcome to me. So please do give your valuable suggestions, which is highly required here to optimize this channel.